Almost any even moderately nervous man or woman will hold a pen as if some unseen force were trying to pull it away, and will write with firmly set jaw, contracted throats, and a powerful tension in the muscles of the tongue, or whatever happens to be the most officious part of this especial individual community. To swing the pendulum to another extreme seems not to enter people's minds when trying to find a happy medium. Writer's paralysis, or even the ache that comes from holding the hand so long in a more or less cramped attitude, is easily obviated by stopping once in an hour or half hour, stretching the fingers wide, and letting the muscles slowly relax of their own accord. Repeat this half a dozen times, and after each exercise, try to hold the pen or pencil with natural lightness. It will not take many days to change the habit of tension to one of ease, although if you are a steady writer, the stretching exercise will always be necessary, but much less often than at first. In lifting a heavy weight, as in nursing the sick, the relief is immediate from all straining in the back by pressing hard with feet on the floor and thinking the power of lifting in the legs. There is true economy of nervous force here, and a sensitive spine is freed from a burden of strain which might undoubtedly be the origin of nervous prostration. I have made nurses practice lifting while impressing the fact forcibly upon them by repetition before they lift, and during the process of raising a body and lowering it, that they must use entirely the muscles of the legs. When once their minds have full comprehension of the new way,